Everybody wants to know what kind of shampoo you use, because your hair is like going. Right here.
Dirt. I'm a big fan of just not using too much.
Perfect. So what are some of your favorite moments from filming this music?
Honestly, we're getting a much greater chance to explore the characters and their individual dynamics. You have to do so much setup, and we're past that. People are familiar with who we are, so you're getting to go further into the characters. And for me, personally, Joe had a secret in season one, so that means sitting back a lot and just going,
I don't want to talk.
Now I, as a character, have to deal with the fact that I'm in a whole new space. I've been hiding from something for so long and denying an aspect of who I am, not really living the fullness of me, and now I'm back out there in the world. My power's been shown, my identity out there, and what does that mean? Where do I fit in? So that means I get to do stuff.
So what are you hoping to explore for the next season?
Just what I said, to explore like what is Joe's place in the world, what does it mean now that he's no longer hiding and his main purpose is to stay off the radar, what does it mean for him to be in the world? How does he participate and interact with it? So, and you know, killing things in the dark.
Are you surprised that you're going to get some romantic drama as well? Sounds like some drama?
Not so surprised as much as I think there's a real decency and honesty there towards the identity crisis of things. I think, you know, when we have relationships, sometimes we overlook the relationship we need to have with ourselves, and that, you know, maybe Joe acts out a little bit and goes out and, you know, yeah. I'll stop there, because I think I should.
I think that makes sense, though. Yeah.
Now, what would you say was the most challenging scene that you filmed in the season, if you can talk about it?
In this season?
Yeah.
Well, we're only on episode 4. We haven't. Okay. We're cross-boarding, which means shooting 2 episodes at a time right now, with 3 and 4.
Gotcha.
So when I go back, I get to shoot a really awesome fight sequence.
How are you prepping for it?
A lot of rehearsal. Okay. We've got an amazing stunt coordinator who's really good about not just making it a kick and a hit, but actually integrating character into the fights and the development of those characters and storylines. So,
oh, cool.
Yeah, it's it takes a village to do any production. That's one of the things I love about being an actor is without a gaffer, without craft services, without the director, without the lighter, without the DP, without the actors, without costumes, without all these different elements and stunts involved, you don't get to create the reality. And we've got a really good team this year.
Were people expecting a season 2, or were you like happily surprised?
Honestly, it was a little bit of a disappointment didn't come sooner. It left me cliffhanging.
Yeah.
I think that, you know, it's... I think it's a really special show. I'd like to see us live for a long time. I think it's something as a fan that I really relate to. The stories that like let you know you're not alone and that there are people in the world that think like you and it doesn't have to be all the same.
Yeah, and are different and different.
Yeah,
okay.
And different rocks.
Yeah.
This is a great time. You know, there's a bunch of populism and hate being tossed around in the world right now. It's acute. But it's also, I think, reactionary. We're seeing a lot of voices to say that different does wrong, that individualism is amazing and not, oh, there's something wrong with you.
Yeah.
And I love that this story participates in that,
yeah,
you know?
I do too.
All walks of life, come on in.
Yeah.
Are we gonna get to see a darker side of Joe, maybe, since we didn't really see much of him except for the, you know, quiet type?
Yeah, like I said, I am a lot more active in this season. And yes, I'm going to... There's a little bit of identity crisis, and with identity crisis usually comes a little acting out. So I might do a little murderous mayhem. But, you know, I'm only killing things that deserve to be killed.
I mean, Angel.
Yeah, you know, and a demon hunter coming. I mean, there may be something going on. You guys saw the trailer.
Yeah,
I mean,
it was great.
I love that Blackheart moment where the two of us are like, hey, nice to meet you. Oh, like you're Blackheart too.
Yeah.
And Josh has been really fun to work with so far, so I have a feeling that this is going to be a really fun season for us.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it was, wasn't it an awesome trailer?
It was.
And that's just the trailer. That's just scratching the surface. There's a lot coming.
Awesome.
Yeah, that was why I thought you'd filmed more.
Yeah.
There's so much in that.
Yeah. The writers are really kicking ass this year. They're really giving it up. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited to see. I've seen the fifth episode. Yeah, apparently we'll get six, so I'm sitting there with bated breath going, what goes next?
That's awesome.
You mentioned that you were doing multiple episodes during the same period of time. But how far in the scripts are you in, even though you're already just filming like episode four?
We're almost done with the third and the fourth. It's really actually great. We've got some really amazing directors this season, and the directors that did one and two and three and four, I think just gives us a real strong platform to kick off the season with, to really just, instead of having disparate voices, instead of having just all disparate voices, to really hone in on the direction and the voice of the show early on.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you.